Welcome to the tale of a delicious adventure in a wonderful land. Can't you tell it? I can already tell it'll be delicious. Can't you smell it already? How I love that gorgeous smell. I'm sure you've all heard of Cadbury's.
Yeah.
Roundtree.
Yeah.
Fry.
Yeah.
Nestle.
Yeah.
Walker.
What's Walker?
Walker? You don't know what Walker is? Why, Walker's chocolate, of course. I admit that Walker's chocolate is fairly new. But it's the most amazing and most extraordinary chocolate to ever exist. Why, Willy Wonka himself is the most amazing, the most fantastic and the most extraordinary chocolate maker the world has ever seen. He's invented things like, well, I'm not going to tell you what he's invented, because you came to see for yourself.
So I'll let you do just that. But before I do, I should perhaps fill you in on what's been happening around here lately. Because Miss Willy Wonka makes the best chocolate in the whole wide world. Three other great chocolate makers known as Mr. Wiggle Grubber, Mr. Prawnose and Mr. Slugworth sent spies in order to discover her secrets. Well, they must have been great spies because soon after, these three chocolate makers began to make such Wonka favorites as ice cream that never melts, chewing gum that never loses its flavor, and chewing gum that you could blow up in huge size before you pop them up. Miss Wonka didn't know who the spies were. She didn't know what to do. And if she continued to operate her factory, all the secrets might be stolen. So she did the only thing she could. She sent all her workers back home and closed the factory.
You might think that would be the end of Mrs. Willy Wonka. But no, sir, not her. After months and months went by, the factory suddenly began operating again. Nobody knew who was running the place. Nobody ever went in and nobody ever came out. The only thing people could see were dancing shadows along the side of the windows. Mighty strange. Anyways, let's get back to the story. Mrs. Willy Wonka has been secretly wrapping five golden tickets under five ordinary chocolate bars.
The candy bars were said to be found anywhere, in any street, in any shop, in any town, in any countries of the world. Upon any counter where Wonka's candies are sold. The five winners will tour Mr. Wonka's new factory and take home enough chocolates for the rest of their lives.
feel very sorry for Mr. Wonka. It's gonna cost him fortune in fudge!
You must be proud of yourself, Augustus.
I am.
Thank you and enjoy your visit, Augustus.
I win!
This is Adya Mehra reporting for the 6 o'clock news at Dassel High.
Tonight with our cabbage soup, we'll have a real birthday banquet. And Grandpa Joe, guess what? I bought you some tobacco. I've decided I'm gonna buy you some tobacco every week.
There's no need, Charlie. I've decided to give it up when you could bring home a loaf of bread and it becomes a banquet. I have no right buying tobacco.
Oh, come on, Grandpa Joe, just this once.
Thanks, Charlie. By the way, have you heard the news today?
No, what news, Grandpa?
Willy Wonka's opening his factory.
Does that mean we can go in and see Miss Wonka?
Well, no, not quite. He has put five golden tickets inside the wrappers of 5 ordinary bars of chocolate, and those who find it will be allowed in and will have lifetimes of supply of chocolate.
Do you think I could be one of the lucky winners?
Why not, Charlie? You have as much chance as everyone else does.
Well, I don't have a bar of chocolate very often. Other kids make fun of me because I don't have any sweets.
Don't worry, Charlie. You don't have to go to the dentist as often as those children.
By the time I come to have my next bar of chocolate, all the lucky golden tickets will be found.
Don't worry, Charlie. Your day will come one day. And maybe it already has.
What do you mean?
Well, I've been saving for this day. And I've got you a little something. Come on now, shut your eyes. Hold your hands out.
A Wonka Whippy Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight?
Yes, Charlie. It's Wonka's Whippy Scrumptious Fudge Mellow Delight. Best of them all. You'll just love it.
Yeah, I know.
And don't worry, dear, if you don't find what you're looking for underneath the wrapper.
Sorry, Grandpa. No luck this time.
Just forget all about those golden tickets and enjoy the chocolate.
We'll share it. I'll save some for Mom and Dad when they get home. I want everyone to taste it.
fine, Charlie. They wouldn't dream of it. It's all yours. Well, let's see the news today.
And here we are in Dasselheim with our lucky winner, Augustus Gloop.
He looks to me like a big, great, greedy nincompoop.
Well, I guess I shouldn't be expecting too much then. But when will things change?
Probably when you least expect it, Charlie.
Alabama Heights with the winner of the second golden ticket, Veruca Salt.
Yeah.
Now, Mrs. Salt, can you tell me exactly how you found the golden ticket?
You see, boys, as soon as Veruca told me that she simply had to have one of those golden tickets, I rushed into town. I started buying all the Wonka bars I could find. I had loaded them into trucks. I had thousands of them, hundreds of thousands. I bought them directly to my factory. Well, I'm in a peanut business and I have about 100 women working for me. So I told them, okay girls, from now on you can stop selling peanuts and start selling apples from chocolate bar instead. And they did. It was so awful seeing Veruca getting more and more upset, and when the news came about Augustus Gloop,
I wanted to be the first.
She was lying on the floor, kicking and yelling. And contented. It took us 3 whole days before we found the ticket.
Shut up, you. It's my golden ticket. You hear me? All mine.
Veruca, dear, smile for the camera.
Okay, Veruca. I hope you enjoy your visit to the factory and get everything you want.
I will. Don't you worry.
This is Shlok Salim for the Priority News.
Well, Violet, congratulations on getting the golden ticket, and I hope you enjoy your visit at Wonka's factory. And here we are, outside the home of the TV family, where 9-year-old Mike has found the fourth golden ticket. Mike, didn't I tell you to keep quiet? Can't you people see I'm watching TV? I wish you wouldn't interrupt me. Bang!
Well, Mike, would you like to tell us how you found the golden ticket?
Well, I first opened a bar of chocolate while watching TV, and there it was. I wasn't very interested. I'd rather watch TV. I eat all my dinners right here in front of the TV.
I see, that's very...
Did I tell you to be quiet? I wish you wouldn't interrupt me. This show's an absolute whiz banger. I watch it every day. I like the gangsters when they start pumping each other full of lead. Bang! 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 Gosh, what would I be doing to be doing that myself? Bang! 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 Bang!
This is Ajmal for the 6 o'clock Friday news.
Bang, 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 bang.
Hi, Charlie. Come, come, sit.
Grandpa, is it really true that Miss Willy Wonka's factory is the biggest in the world?
Of course it's true. It's almost as 50 times as big as any other.
And is it really true that Miss Wonka is the cleverest chocolate maker on the planet?
True. He's the most amazing, the most fantastic, the most clever chocolate maker the world has ever seen. I thought everyone knew that.
Well, I knew she was famous and I knew she was very clever.
Clever? She's more than that. She's a magician with chocolate. Once she had made an ice cream which would stay frozen even if kept in the sun.
But that's impossible.
I know it's impossible, but Miss Willy Wonka has done it. Charlie?
Yes, Grandpa?
I have little something for you. I'm so forgetful. Where did I keep the bar of chocolate?
Interesting. another bar of chocolate. But I gave you money to buy tobacco, not chocolate for me.
Just forget it and just have it.
No, Grandpa Joe. Why don't you open it?
You know we don't have a hope, really. Don't you?
Yeah, I know. But why don't you open it?
But there's always a tiny chance that it might be the one.
Why don't you open it, Grandpa?
Okay. Which end do you think I should open first?
That corner, top right. Just tear up a little bit.
Like that?
Yes, yes. Now a little more.
I'm too nervous. You do it.
No, Grandpa Joe. You can do it.
Okay. No luck this time. Well, I think having nothing is a great place to start because then you have nothing to lose.
Don't go attacking Mr. Walker. Remember your manners.
I don't care, Dad. I didn't ask him for a golden ticket. I'm missing all my favorite TV shows. I hope Mom remembers to record them. Bang! 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 Those must be the other lucky golden ticket winners. Do you know who's who, Grandpa?
I think I can tell by looking at them. That must be Augustus Gloop. That must be Violet Beauregard. She chose one piece of gum for 3 whole months.
I don't know if she's going to be very nice, Grandpa.
Well, she's pretty on the inside, but I'm not sure about the inside. She's used to have everything, and if she doesn't get anything, she'll scream.
Come on, a few more steps.
Excuse me, we're here from the press. He's fine.
Oh,
then you should know all about it. Terrible countries. Nothing but thick jungles infested with the most dangerous beasts in the world. Horn swaggers. Snow swaggers. Terrible. Wicked. Wagger dollars. Did you know?
Yumba. wonderful, Grandpa? Doesn't it have wonderful taste?
Go on the field! I need the whole thing! Still, I won't be hungry!
What's the matter with your river walker? Is it polluted?
It's not chocolate! Every drop of the river is hot, melted chocolate of the finest quality. The waterfall is the most important part as it mixes the chocolate. No other factory in the world mixes its chocolate by waterfall. The pipes suck up the chocolate and carry it all the
should know. I'm an expert when it comes to gum.
My dear Violet, this gum is a whole 3-course meal all by itself.
Nonsense.
Ma'am, when I start selling this gum, it will be the end of kitchens, cooking, and shopping. This piece of gum just happens to be roast beef, tomato soup, and blueberry pie.
Do you mean it's tomato soup,
Where is she going?
Ram, just sit on a slide.
Just go, just go. It's okay, go. Go, go, go.
Parents too. won't let you down, Miss.
I'm sure you won't. Now we must go fetch your family.
What? You mean Grandpa George, Grandma Josephine, and Grandma Georgina, and Grandpa Jokin, and my mom and dad can all live here with you?
Of course they can, until you're old enough to run the place, that is.
It's like a dream come true.
That's what dreams are made of. Imagination!
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the stars of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory! Mighty B, Mr. TV, Violet Beauregard, Veruca Salt, Mrs. Beauregard, Augustus Duke, Mrs. Salt, and of course, Willy Wonka, and Charlie Bucket, and Grandpa Bucket, and the incredible Loompa Loompa! And of course, the family in the Hive! Come on up, everybody! Come on up, come on up, come on up! Wow, the family in the Hive is getting so big, I can't count everybody. Yeah, we're really getting big and tall. Maybe we're having Vitamin Wonka. Wow! Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Did you guys enjoy the show?
Yeah.
Yes! Whew. We are so glad. Well, a lot of effort went into that show, right? Right?
Yes.
And I think this is a very well-deserved bow that we need to take. As one team, everybody's holding a hand. Hold hands. All right. And this is how we do it. Up to three. Down to three. Back to three. Wow. Okay. I know it's a late night and I know it's a school day tomorrow, so I won't take too much time. I think some really amazing stuff happens on this stage. Especially when you have such a big cast, right, and it's a big ensemble, and so much of your work is actually reacting and supporting. It's not so much about learning your lines, but it's about so much of listening. Do you guys agree?
Yes.
Yeah, my God, you have to be listening all the time, you have to be switched on all the time, your face has to be on all the time, every muscle in your body has to believe that this is not Zabi Ladies Club, but this is Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory, and that is so hard. I promise you, it is so hard. It's hard for us as adults to do. I mean, we've been doing this our whole lives. I'm so proud of these children for having done what they did. Thank you for being the best team. We have a lot to learn from you about how to make a good team. And I really am genuinely so incredibly proud of you. Okay, I won't take too much of your time. Anybody here coming to the Hive Children Festival for the first time? In this, yeah, oh wow. Lovely. Amazing, amazing, amazing. To all the babies whose hands are up, listen, I'll tell you this, okay? You can walk into a Hive class any day of the week, anytime. You don't have to be someone who's done like 25 school plays before. You don't have to be the teacher's pet. Everybody gets to do this. Everybody gets to be on stage and share that voice and be the center of that moment and share their ideas with an audience. That's what the Hive does the best. So please come by. Three simple asks from you. Number one, Live at Hive. You guys all follow Live at Hive, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. We've got some great stuff going on social, and we're going to have even more exciting stuff through the summer. Second thing is we've got some super summer camps coming up in 5 locations. 2 in Baitabai, 1 in Alnada, 1 in JLJ, and 1 in Silicon Oasis. And we're growing, and we need your help to spread the word. So if you've got friends in any of these neighborhoods or who will be close by, tell them, because all these scripts are ready to action for the next camp and the next round of kids and the next bunch of families. So tell them all about it. And the third is, we've got more shows of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory coming up next weekend. And lots more kids are going to be doing this. And we want them to have an audience as wonderful as you. So please go out and spread the word about the festival.
It's bleh.
Hey,
wrong. It's free because really this is how it should be. Shouldn't be 2,000 dirhams to go to Dubai Opera to watch a show, right? You should be able to take your kids and do this instead of sitting in front of their iPads. And unless we make those two equal, unless it's the same, it's as easy, it's as accessible, how will our children ever be off their devices and watching live actors, right? Right? And hence, the festival is free, we've removed all the barriers, we just want people to come, that's it. We want to have full audiences, so please do spread the word for us. Okay, enough of my talking. Ladies and gentlemen, we shall return your babies to you in 100% original quality on the other side of this door. Thank you for being an incredible, incredible audience. Thank you so much. Thank you.